Let's start off by telling me about your practice. Tell me about it as a patient who, I don't know anything at all about you, what type of a practice you have, what your specialty is. Just tell me about your practice and what I can expect as a patient.
I have a practice where we're all about giving our patients a delightful dental experience. And indeed, that's an audacious claim. And so this keeps us really accountable to that claim. And it's all about changing people's perception of what a dental visit should be about. And you know, typically patients out there are terrified going to the dentist, and we just want to really make a difference in that and really get the people the help they need so that they can have a healthy and beautiful smile for a lifetime.
What do you find is the patients, there are all different types of patients, and you said most of them are fearful of dentistry, but what patients do you find, for lack of a better term, gravitate or get attracted to your practice? What are they looking for? What are they in hopes of with regard to the treatments that you do and so forth? But tell me about your patients.
Well, the typical patients we see are people that have had less than desirable dental experiences. They're not necessarily in fear, but they're looking for better. And so in their quest for better, they ultimately come across us and they come in to check us out to see if indeed we're the real deal. And you know, a lot of them come from some other family or friend telling them about us. Some of them come from some things they might have read online and things like that. And when they do get in, then they really see that we're patient-centric, patient-focused office, and that makes a whole lot of difference.
What do you find are your challenges in your business, not in dentistry, but in your business, in running your practice, in growing your practice? What do you find are the challenges that you are having with your practice specifically, that you've come to Jerry Jones and so forth, and we'll get into that, but for you specifically, what are your challenges with the business?
Well, my challenges professionally with my dental office is really, you know, finding those amazing team members that can give a patient that amazing experience. And that's one of it. And, you know, the reason I came, or the reason why I kept looking out there and then I stumbled upon Jerry Jones is because I was looking for something that's more on the guerrilla marketing level, where your copyright speaks to people and not just a flash in the pan kind of headline, but really tells a story that's compelling and people can relate to. And it's not a fad, it's just a really tried and true way of attracting really, I don't want to use the word quality because every patient is quality, but attracting patients that are not insurance focused, they're just really looking for someone to take great care of them. So this is what led me to Jerry Jones. And I have dabbled into all kinds of books and all that, and there is a guru I know of. His name is Dan Kennedy, and I've read a lot of his materials. And I started finding some similarities with Jerry Jones materials, and that was when I knew that it had to be the real deal, because Dan Kennedy shoots straight, and he's very compelling, and Jerry Jones is the same way, yeah.
Your first communication or your first contact with Jerry, because I'm sure being in dentistry as long as you've had, there are other gurus out there. There are other people to follow. We talked about Jay Geyer and so forth, and they're not necessarily the same as Jerry. But how did you find Jerry to be when you talk? Because you, what you just said is you. It sounds like you had an expectation already from what you learned about Jerry. But talk to me about your first contact with Jerry and what that was like, what you felt or what you heard. And where I'm getting at is that how did you know this was the right person?
Well, I contacted Jerry, his company, and I asked to speak with Jerry. And they said to me that he will call me. And he called me, I think it was a weekend, it was in the evening, and that blew me away. And I got talking to him, and I just realized that he's not a fluffy kind of guy. He's like all about results, which is what I'm looking for. And I had read up about him before getting on the phone with him, you know, studied his copies and things like that. And it doesn't get more compelling than that. It really doesn't. The biggest thing for me with Jerry Jones is the fact that he's very systematic in how he corresponds with the public to really get them to look at you differently. You're more than just commodity dentistry. You're more than just, I participate in your insurance, so come to me. It's more about a connection and really connecting with patients where they want to be met.
So, how long have you been now, I'll use the word connected, with Jerry? How long has that been now since the first contact? And this is your first meeting, this is your first mastermind you've been to, but how long now have you been connected with Jerry?
Since December 2015.
So only a few months.
Yes.
And that. What have you learned in those few months? Because you talked about Jerry's very systematic in communicating with the public, with getting that message out there. But some places that I've been, it takes you a while to get up and running and get, you know, understanding. It sounds like you had an immediate connection with Jerry and you were kindred spirits, if you will. Mm-hmm. But what have you learned now in being associated with Jerry in just these few months, in this very short period of time?
Well, for one, he has, I like to think of it like a goodie bag, like a treasure trove of amazing ideas. He has a customer hub or a client hub, whatever it's called, where you can log in and see different ideas, kind of like a frequently asked questions section, and you can dig in whatever your challenges might be. You get answers there, and it's just a really different way. I can imagine this might not be for everyone, but it's definitely for that person that's looking for amazing results and is ready to take responsibility for what it's going to take. He gives you all the tools, and all you have to do is tweak it just slightly, and it's off to the races. And I have my own personal kind of concierge that answers me back like that. And I really feel empowered because I have all the tools. I have a person that I can bounce ideas off of, and it's just about taking it to the marketplace and seeing it manifest. And, you know, this short time that I've known him, I have used quite a number of his style in things around the office internally, on social media, and the response has been amazing. Yes.
The response you're talking about, what help me understand what we're talking about with regard to response. Are you talking about the change that you see in your team or your staff, or the response that you're getting from patients, increased number of patients? Tell me, help me understand what your reference is with regard to response.
Well, it's both on the patient level and also on the team level. It's helping me. Like right now, I'm in a period of looking for an associate, and his way of actually seeking out an associate is so refreshing, if I might say that, because everything is a system, right? If you want predictable results, you need to follow a system. And that's what Jerry brings to the table. And when it comes to my team, the most mind-blowing thing that we've incorporated is his 10-step phone call system. Now, I've been to several places, and you always learn something great from places, from different places, especially if you're willing to put in the work. So I've had great phone answering systems, but Jerry's is a 10th step, which at first it seemed rather much. But when I got the CDs, I delegated a CD to each of my team members, had them come back to present the meat, the juice from the CD that we could implement right now. And we got over that process in a week. And the following Monday when we incorporated the new system, it was amazing. Because not only were we closing more new patients on the phone, we were getting a better emotional connection with our patients on the phone. And then at the huddles in the morning, we could actually, the new patient call concierge could actually share something that was on a very emotional level that the patient had shared with them on the phone with the rest of the team, especially the back office team, where we could actually use in communicating with the patient and really come to help them in a more expeditious way, really connecting with them. That was mind-blowing because I had been using something that was very great. It took us from 30 new patients a month to about 50 new patients a month, 60 new patients. Now we're like edging 100, and a lot of times we're actually even weeding out some of the calls because, hey, we can, thanks to Jerry Jones.
Yeah.
Yes.
With, I had a question and I had a senior moment and it went, so forgive me on that. Your first day and your first experience with the Jerry Jones Mastermind group. Tell me about today's experience. What was that like? First of all, what was your expectation coming in? What did you expect coming into this room today? Because I'm sure you've been in other dental groups. What was your expectation or your hope coming into today? And then once you tell me that, what was now at the end of the day, what was the experience? Tell me what that was like.
My expectation coming in today, coming in for the mastermind, was, okay, I'm going to hang out with, you know, my colleagues that are highly engaged in their practices. I'm going to hang out with people that are, you know, playing at a higher level, and I'm going to learn from them. It's going to be so powerful because it's an open forum and everyone's going to be willing to share. And now that I've come here, it has surpassed my expectations because I have made connections. I mean, people were so real, people were so giving, people were so open and so authentic and so vulnerable. And there's nothing better than that, because often we're in our offices, in our own little world, and yes, you have some close professional colleagues that you can call on, but there's just a magic that happens when you come to a group of people that you all have similar backgrounds, and everybody's willing to share what their wins are, what their challenges are. It's just really powerful. I think everyone needs to experience this. Everyone needs to come to a mastermind. It's beyond words.
You're different than many dentists. And what I mean by different is that you are outgoing and you are sharing. You're no holds barred, if I would use that term. You're no BS, if I will. Is that one of the things I noticed, that you weren't a wallflower in this meeting today. Meaning, even though you're the new person, if you will, you weren't a wallflower, is that you were here to get engaged, to be engaged, and to hear and get the engagement from other people, which many people don't do in a mastermind. They just go and try to be a fly on the wall and so forth. Could you speak to me about how much more valuable it is to be engaged? And what I mean engaged is not just listening, but being involved and participating and being in the room. As Jerry said this morning, be present, be engaged, and so forth. How valuable is that for you? Because it seems to be natural for you. It's not for a lot of dentists. But how much more powerful is it for you to be engaged with the people that you're here? And you're investing quite a bit of money to be here. But how much more powerful is it to be engaged than to just be an observer on the wall?
Well, you know, I have only recently realized the power in being so highly engaging and contributing at a higher level, because success begets success. So when you're willing to share your wins with people and you come across to them from a place of vulnerability and from a place where you're authentic and you really go from, look where I used to be, look where what it took me to get to, from where I used to be to where I am now, and by the way, I don't have two heads. If I did it, you can do it too. There's a lot of power in that. I've been very fortunate in that I have had the blessing of having people so into me. So it is indeed an honor. When I come to things like this, it's really like, okay, I have blessed you. And now I want you to be a blessing with what I've blessed you with. So it's an honor for me to share what I've learned through pain, through traumatic experiences with others, in the hope that they don't have to go through the same traumatic experience and they don't have to run around the block like I did. Because then someone will be compelled to share something else that then can benefit me, and I don't have to spend a whole year reaching the results they did. I could reach that result in a day, in a week. And that is what a mastermind does that makes it so powerful. And it's truly a blessing to be here. And
I'm gonna close, the last question I have is this morning, I'm gonna close with the beginning, if you will. This morning, you told your story, and I won't do it justice, so I want you to tell it. But you said that you drew a line in the sand, that you reached a point in your practice. Tell me about that. Tell me about that story, about that point you reached where you had to draw a line in the sand. And then also, the why you do. You talked about your mission statement, but why do you do what you do?
Well, my story is simply this. I started a practice bright-eyed like most other people, and I had dreams. I thought I could conquer the practice of dentistry. And I wasn't well equipped. And I got to the point where I started believing my own excuses. And even though I have never been a person that plays victim, I started to realize I started making a lot of excuses and giving a lot of reasons why this A and B wasn't equal to, you know, what you typically, or 1 + 1 wasn't equal to 2. And indeed, you could validate that. You know, the practice wasn't in the right location, the team members were that, and blah, blah, blah. But it wasn't until I took a hard look at the common denominator in all of this. And what I saw staring back at me was myself. That was the turning point for me, because that showed me that everything I had been doing that caused me to almost fail was as a result of me. I was solely responsible for all things by commission or omission. And it wasn't until I came to that point to take responsibility that I really started seeing massive change. And indeed, the level of your success seldomly supersedes the level of your personal development. And I started getting rid of my stinking thinking and really formulating a new mind, having a renewal of mind. And this was what powerfully galvanized a different way of seeing things. And then I became more audacious about, hey, what if I stop believing my excuses? And because after all, if I did believe my excuses, how would they serve me? And so now I have gone from a place where I almost failed to where the sky is not even the limit. What gets me up every morning is knowing that I can impact a person or even my team members, because in all this personal journey or professional journey, I really became a better dentist. I became a better wife, a better mother, a better leader. And it's really, really about the journey at this point. So every day I welcome with, wow, what does this day have in store for me? And how am I going to leave my mark on whoever I meet today? And that is so fulfilling. It's about living with purpose. And in my practice, our purpose is to impact the patients and the community we serve with a healthy mouth and a beautiful smile that lasts a lifetime, and to create raving fans. How many people can say they can create a raving fan out of their patients? It takes a lot of intention and it takes a lot of work, but when you see it as your purpose, you don't see it as work, and it's just an exciting time in my professional life. I thank God.
Excellent. Well said.
Thank
That's
you.
All I have.